Hey everyone, VNodes versus PNodes. What are these friggin' things? What are nodes anyway in blockchain? And what types of nodes are there? So I'll dive into these details in this little video and I'll get through all of this. What are nodes? And in blockchain, how did they evolve? What are the different types of nodes? And what do you need to know in order to understand all these things? So if you like content like this, please don't forget to give me that like button. I really appreciate it. And also subscribe to my channel. All right, so nodes, the term node comes from graph theory, right? It's just like mathematical graph theory, and a graph is something that consists of nodes and edges, right? So a node is kind of a communication endpoint or a hub, and the edges connect these things, right? And that those terms have been adopted by blockchains. So blockchain consists of many, many servers. So what's a server anyway? A server is just a computer, right? A computer that has been designed to communicate and to communicate and talk to other computers, then it's called a server, right? If it's a computer that's built to communicate with you, like humans, that's not a server, right? That would be called just a client, right? So that's what we used to use, like laptops and stuff like that. The servers are just built to communicate with other computers, so that's why they don't have a screen typically or a keyboard or anything like that, because you know they don't communicate with humans, or at least that's not their main purpose, right? Okay, so we have these nodes, right? A blockchain consists of all these nodes, and often it's being said that it's important that you run your own node, and I absolutely agree with that, because if you run your own node, you make the blockchain more decentralized. And that's what blockchain's all about. It's all about decentralization, and it's about decentralization of control, right? It's not so much about geographical decentralization. That's also a thing, right? But many people try to sell you on, haha, we're decentralized just because it's geographically decentralized. But in the end, there's one guy in control or one central organization in control. For example, like with Wikipedia, right? It's one central organization that's in control. If you make a change there or an edit, anyone can, but the central organization could just delete the fact that you even try to make an edit and nobody will see it anymore, right? So it's a centralized system. So now with VNodes and PNodes, what are these things now, right? So VNodes are just the validator nodes. So if you're in a blockchain, the most important thing to see there is validator nodes, right? Especially if you're in a smart contract enabled blockchain, right? I'm not so much talking about Bitcoin or Litecoin or Dogecoin here, which are not about smart contracts, right? They are just about currency. But the world starts becoming interesting when we look at programmable blockchains, blockchains that have smart contracts, right? So that started with Ethereum, and there are many others out there. I personally am a big fan of Solana because Solana is really, really scalable. And we are adding a scalable storage layer that's missing. And so it's missing in any smart contract blockchain. There's no scalable storage layer. And we're adding that to the blockchain. It's called Xandeum. If you want to know more, link in the description, xandeum.com. So we have our own nodes also. And, you know, with running a node early on, we're still under development, right? But you can already run a node and you can run it in our incentivized DevNet. So you can earn the Xand tokens even before we're live. While we're still developing things, it is super, super exciting, especially for guys who want to be in a new, you know, world-changing project really, really early on. So I recommend going to Xandeum.com and consider getting a node license or two. And there are two different types of nodes, right? So we have the V nodes and the P nodes. That's the subject of this video, right? V nodes are the validator nodes. P nodes are the provider nodes, right? So how can we scale the storage layer, right? We just say the storage is not contained on the validators, as with the other chains out there, right? So there is a built-in storage facility in Solana, right? It's called Solana Accounts. There is a built-in storage facility in Ethereum, right? It's just, if you want to store a terabyte there, it's going to cost you billions and billions and billions of dollars, just because this terabyte would need to be stored on each and every validator, on 2,200 validators. Each of them needs to keep it in RAM, in memory. And think about, you know, 10 apps do that, then that's 10 terabytes and stuff like that. You would kind of blow up the whole blockchain with that. That's why it's so super expensive. And that's why it's not scalable, right? And we achieve that scalability through adding, through offloading the storage to PNodes. And PNodes are provider nodes, storage provider nodes. Their only task is providing storage, right? So if you want to store, if you develop an app, and as the app developer, you need to store a terabyte of data, which basically each and every app developer needs to do. If you have a few hundred, a few thousand customers, it's going to be a lot of storage. So you can do that on the Xandeum chain with the PNodes, the provider nodes. We are starting a wait list now for people to get on the list to be the very, very first to run their own storage provider nodes on the Xandeum blockchain in our DevNet, right? So soon you will be able to sign up for a wait list there. So if you're not on our email list or not on our Discord, sign up there. Just go to Xandeum.com and sign up for our email list and or our Discord so that you get all the news, and also subscribe to this channel and hit the bell notification to get all the news when the PNode waitlist will open. And it's just going to be a few weeks until that happens. All right. That was the VNodes and PNodes things. I'm Blockchain Bernie. Thanks so much for watching. Catch you guys later. Peace.